Hi, my name is James Olson, and as a lawyer assisting this campaign, I couldn't resist the urge to add a few disclaimers. Due care has been taken, and no baby seals were injured in the making of this video. The man flying the jet is a trained professional. Do not attempt it at home. The photos you see of Doc in uniform are not an endorsement by the military. Furthermore, the values expressed in this video may cause liberals stomach ulcers when combined with Kool-Aid. Thank you.
Our contest is not only whether we ourselves shall be free, but whether there shall be left to mankind an asylum on earth for civil and religious liberty.
I support Dan Severson for U.S. Senate because as I've come into my own as a grassroots activist, Dan has been there. I've known him. I've talked to him. Now, a lot of politicians, they show up during the election year because they need your vote, but Dan's someone who's been in lockstep with the grassroots all the way.
Hi, I'm Kathy Joe, and I'd like to tell you a little about Doc. He's committed. He's been my faithful husband for 36 years, a loving, devoted father to our two children, Nicole and Joshua, a role model for our family. He's humble, born in small-town Mora, Minnesota, to two teachers who instilled in him the duties of faith, hard work, and devotion.
When your rights are threatened by government constraints, who do you want keeping you free?
My dad is awesome. He may come across as unassuming, but he is a fighter. After many months in traction, he was told he would never fly again. But my dad, that didn't stop him. He's a warrior. Military commander, top gun pilot, 22 years in uniform.
Did you know Doc is also an inventor? He thinks outside the box. When he sees a problem, it's in his nature to find a solution.
The biggest problem with our nation is the size of government. I have a history of shrinking government. As the minority whip, we held the line on $3.2 billion in tax increases and actually shrunk government for the first time in Minnesota history.
I support Doc Severson because he's a man of integrity and consistency. He does not waver from conservative principles. Go Doc!
During my time in the House, I represented a watershed district that had been taxed over $800,000 over a 20-year period, resulting in not one project being completed. I ended that watershed and that tax. In 2005, I carried the marriage amendment, and we passed it in the House of Representatives. It went to the Senate. The Senate blocked it. It didn't die. I carried the marriage amendment for the next 3 years until I got out of the legislature. Steve Rodwell carried it. They successfully passed it because we have both bodies this time, and it will be on the ballot this fall. In 2010, I fought for photo ID and narrowly lost that battle to a Soros-funded incumbent, but we won the war. Photo ID will be on the ballot in November. I have a statewide network of volunteers, activists, and minority outreach groups waiting for their marching orders to get out the vote. I can take this fight to Amy Klobuchar, and we can win control of the Senate.
I support Dan Severson because I trust him. In both his personal and professional life, he has proven himself a man of his word.
We need a new conservative guard to hold the line in Washington. I've held a conservative line in the past, and I can do it again. This race is ours to win. In the last election, I got nearly a million votes. I'm proven and I'm vetted. Now we have the new Americans and the minorities to join us. We can increase that number. Join me.
When your civil and religious liberties are in the government's crosshairs, who do you want as your wingman?
The president and his followers in the Senate are twisting this country into a socialist gimme state, and they are subverting the Constitution to do it. With Obamacare, they are eliminating the autonomy of the individual to choose what to purchase and what not to purchase.
Join us!
Hey, Dad. I'm so proud of you. I wish I could be there with you today at the convention. I'm proud of all of the hard work you've done, the time and the sacrifice to allow Minnesota the opportunity to vote for a statesman.
This election is a referendum on America's fate, and we must win. I have the leadership, the experience, and the statewide exposure. Join us.
Oops.
Join us. Join us.
Minnesota Republican delegates. I'm State Senator Paul Gazelka from Central Minnesota, and I'm here to endorse Doc Severson for United States Senate. I got to tell you, Doc Severson is somebody that I've prayed with, I've laughed with, I've cried with in battles, in fun times, in bad times, and he's the kind of guy that we want for state senator. I served in the House a few years back with Doc Severson, and I got to tell you, he is proven. That is the one thing that you need to know, the difference between him and the other candidates who I also admire, is Doc Severson is proven. If you look at some of the things that we talked about on there, the marriage amendment, Doc Severson didn't just vote for it, he was willing to be on the tip of the spear to carry that forward when he had many, many voices against him saying, don't do this. Not just Democrats, not just Republicans. Doc Severson was not afraid to be the tip of the spear. You look at photo ID. Well, you can clap. I'd clap about that one. It takes a bulldog. It takes a bulldog. Doc Severson also took on photo ID for voting. He was one of the very first ones to say, this is a problem. Let's move this forward. Doc Severson's that kind of guy. He's proven. But the other major area that I think we're all concerned about is fiscal responsibility. Minnesota is like a small microcosm of what happens at the federal level. And you know what? We had big budget deficits just like they do, just on a smaller level. But it seemed big to us down there. But I got to tell you, Doc Severson was one of those people that would not back down, knew that we had to shrink government spending, knew that we had to rein it in, that we could not let it grow out of control. He was the minority whip when they actually shrunk spending in Minnesota. It's the only time ever that we shrunk spending. I wasn't there, he was. This year we had a $6 billion budget shortfall, but to balance the budget, we simply slowed the growth. Doc Severson and that group, they actually cut government spending. I think we need that in Washington. I'll tell you, I wish I was a cheerleader so I could just get you revved up, but I'm just a common sense kind of guy that says I know what it needs to get done and I know who can get it done. But let me tell you one more thing about Doc Severson. He is, like I said, I've been with him through good times and bad, and he's the kind of guy that you want down there. He has proven Christian character. His love and faith for God and country are, there's no comparison. I've seen it. I've been by him. I've witnessed it. His love and faithfulness for his wife and family and friends and all those around him, he's true. He's sure. He's proven. Folks, I want you to join me in endorsing Doc Severson for United States Senate. Thank you.
Chair Shortridge, fellow delegates, esteemed guests, my name is Eva Ng, and a shout out to Lacqui County, the farmers who are working so hard and took the day off to be here. Thank you for the privilege of addressing this assembly. The last time I did this was in 2009 when I ran for mayor of St. Paul.
Yeah, Eva.
To refresh your memory, I worked 30 years in the private sector as a presidential fast tracker and as a turnaround specialist. And, sorry about that. At the age of 38, I became CEO of a small company, a manufacturing company, and I learned very fast that when you hire the best people, you start with the character. You know that items on the resume can be trained. However, a person's character is usually immutable. Today, I take great pleasure in having the opportunity to speak with you about a man of long-term vision and impeccable character, Dan Doc Severson. I met him during our project to protect your vote, and you heard all about it today because he put muscle into it. We got voter protection on the ballot this November. When he ran that race as Secretary of State in 2010, he garnered nearly 1 million votes. If he had converted a few more thousand, he would have sealed the deal. When I had my 2009 race, I experienced similar things. Because we saw the same things, we got together and we said, how can we convert those few thousand votes? So we looked, and look what we have. We have people in this country and in this state who have experienced oppression, like my parents have, and they don't want to see it ever again, and they don't want you to see it ever. Okay? So we reach into the new American communities and we found them. As a result of 2 years of work, Doc made inroads with the Somalians, the Hmongs, the Hispanic, the Cambodians, and others. The results? Doc enjoys unwavering support from Hmong veterans who estimated their voting bloc to be between 50 and 80,000. Quoting Hmong community leader Shia Lo, he says, Doc is someone who does what he says. In all my dealings with him, he has been a man of his word, a trustworthy man. Ogaden community leader Abdi Karin says, we are 30,000 strong in the cities, and we are 100% behind Doc. Cafe Con Leche, Republicans, is a national GOP group, and they are wholeheartedly endorsing Doc. Cetra Kirch, a good friend of mine of the community, of the Cambodian community, shows his love by running a ground game of his own in his community. And today, he brought his own delegation, and they are supporting Doc 100%. As I said, Doc is a man of long-term vision and impeccable character. He never brags about himself, so we have to do some of it for him. Do you know Doc is a small businessman, a physics major, and an inventor? He and members of his family patented a way to leverage the visible light spectrum of LEDs for use in communications. What a genius idea. Oh yes, applications are being developed for market as we speak. As a manufacturer, I appreciate a good invention and the enterprise it creates. As a voter in the great state of Minnesota, I can appreciate a man who possesses discernment, strong work ethic, honor, integrity, and the rare and noble quality of servant leadership.
Yeah.
With tremendous enthusiasm, I second the nomination of Dan Doc Severson for United States Senate.
Phone. Yeah, I did. Still $15.7 trillion. That has at least doubled since the time that Amy Klobuchar has come into office. Doubled. Yeah, fact. Amy is aggressive. She is mean and she will not pull punches this election. Minnesota has traditionally gone its own way in sending a message to the nation about who we think is best to represent Minnesota. Let's do it again. Let's send a message that we will take this election seriously, that we are in it for the long haul. My name is Nicole Severson. I'm Doc Severson's daughter. Today, let's put a seasoned 22-year plus warrior, a statesman, both a political and military veteran. He's a strategist, a man with a backbone of steel. He is a fourth generation Minnesotan, a third generation veteran who continues to pass the legacy forward in our family. He is a faithful family man and husband, a man with a passion and heart. He has the name. He carries the Constitution in his pocket, and he knows the issues. He is the only man who can take Amy on and win, my dad and my hero, Doc Severson.
Hello, State Committee.
This is overwhelming. A lot of faces out there. I'm not going to stand here today and tout my conservative credentials. You folks know me. I'm the only one running with a proven track record of leadership and reforming government. The question before you today is, who is the best candidate to win in November? I humbly submit to you, I am that candidate. And let me tell you why. I'm the only candidate here with name recognition and an effective statewide ground game. Since my endorsement by Dick Morris, the national grassroots outreach has grown over 730 donors nationwide in just 2 weeks. And that's just the beginning. Dick Morris said it best. This Senate race will get national attention. Republicans don't just need 51 seats in November. We need 56, 57, 58 seats to repeal Obamacare, address the $15.7 debt, $15.7 trillion debt, save our economy, and protect our liberties. The candidate who wins this endorsement, barring any October surprises, will get lots of outside funding, enough to get us within striking distance. But all of that money isn't going to be enough to take us over the top. And this is why. In 2010, we had four constitutional offices up for election: the governor, auditor, secretary of state, and attorney general. That year, we had huge wins at our back. So huge that we went from small minorities to large majorities in the Minnesota House and in the Minnesota Senate for the first time in 38 years. That's awesome. Friends, we lost all four constitutional offices. The fact is, we haven't won a statewide office since 2006. Why is that? Because the demographics of Minnesota are changing, and our party isn't changing with it. Our minority groups are growing, and we aren't reaching out to them. In 1990, minorities made up 6% of the state's population. In 2008, it rose to almost 17%, and it continues to grow. In 2010, we had only 18% of the vote in the inner city. We need to get 23% or more in order to win a statewide race. Just bump it up 5, maybe 6% max. That's the only way we win a statewide race. We have completely mined Greater Minnesota. We can't squeeze 5 or 6 more points out there. We can't gain 5 or 6 more points. And we can gain 5 or 6 more points in the inner city. We can do that. We need to do what we should have been doing for all these years. We need to reach out to conservative groups in the inner city, Greater Minnesota, that vote Democrat, the new Americans and the minorities. The good news is that tens of thousands of these new conservative voters are welcoming us with open arms, if we are sincere and willing. These are friends. These that you have before you today are friends and leaders standing with us today from some of these communities. They have asked to be here in support of my campaign. These new Americans and other groups of people have come here for the liberties of our country alone affords. Many of these groups come from countries with oppressive governments. They love freedom, they love liberty, they love America. America offers greater opportunity and prosperity than any other country in the world. They come here because they want to achieve the American dream. They believe in hard work, personal responsibility, and limited government. I am the only candidate who has reached out to these minority communities, and in fact, I have spent the last 2 years developing relationships with them. Here's the reality. My relationship won't translate into votes for other campaigns. A tested personal trust has been forged between us. They have already dealt with the Democrats who promise and don't deliver. I've got the Ogaden community, 30,000 strong, that are willing to back me in this race and this campaign. 30,000, that's one group. I've major inroads into the relationships with the Hmong, the Cambodian, the Somali, and the Latino. My campaign has a statewide exposure and broad network of activists who are poised to ignite a fire that will burn until November. That, friends, is the only way we can possibly win this election. And I'm the only one who can do it. When I win, I will go to Washington, and the first bill that I will submit to the is the sunset clause to all federal agencies and regulations. That bill will eliminate unconstitutional federal agencies and programs and set up a review cycle to look at program performance. I will join conservative activists in repealing the Obamacare and Dodd-Frank bill and audit the Fed. So I ask you, what will it take to win against Senator Klobuchar, and who is best positioned to do that? It will take a credible statewide campaign, a credible statewide name recognition. I am that candidate. So today, I am humbly asking for your vote. Let's turn Minnesota red and take this U.S. Senate seat this November. I'm asking for your support. May God bless you for all that you're doing here today. May God bless the great state of Minnesota and the great country of the United States. Thank you so much. Yeah.